Hello, everyone. Welcome to Engineering Today, and we'll be presenting you four latest news today. On the 30th of October, NASA submitted an official letter to the United States Federal Communications Commission, FCC, in accordance with a request by Texas-based company AST & Science to operate a network of up to 243 satellites about 720 kilometers above Earth's surface. The satellite group, named Space Mobile, will provide broadband service directly to cell phones. The Space Mobile satellites will send very large antenna apparatus that covers an area of about 9,700 square feet. The Space Mobile satellites will therefore have quite big areas to roam. This would increase the probability of collisions or close flybys with other spacecraft. But the space agency cares quite a bit about that orbital region. A train's average altitude is 705 kilometers, but the satellites get as close to Earth as 690 kilometers and as far away as 740 kilometers. A train, which is a group of 10 Earth observation missions, is operated by NASA, the U.S. Geological Survey, and several international partners that travel around Earth in the same orbit. In a letter signed by Samantha Fonder, a representative of NASA, it says, "The AST constellation would be essentially collocated within the A-train if the proposed orbit altitude is chosen." According to NASA's calculations, moving safely through the Space Mobile satellites might require 1,500 spacecraft maneuvers and 15,000 planning activities per year for the A-train's handlers. That equates to about 4 maneuvers and 40 planning activities every day. The letter also reads AST and Science to consider alternate orbit regimes for this constellation, perhaps notably below the A-train constellation, in order to allow for a more manageable safety of flight situation for a constellation of such large satellites. AST and Science founder Abel Avelin explained that the company knows what it's doing, even though it has yet to launch any satellites to orbit. The company is building a scaled-down prototype of a Space Mobile spacecraft and plans to launch it in the second half of 2021, Avelin said. AST and Science said that Space Mobile wouldn't create any collision risk with NASA's A-train. The company's calculations found that each of the network's satellites has just 1 in 5,000 chance to collide with one another. If AST and Science launches all the 243 satellites, then the probability of a random collision would be 1 out of 20. Besides Space Mobile, other companies which are progressing for bigger broadband connections are Amazon, OneWeb, and SpaceX. SpaceX has launched nearly 900 satellites for its Starlink mega constellation and are already rolling out a public beta testing campaign for its broadband service. Amazon aims to launch about 3,200 broadband satellites to LEO, and OneWeb has already lofted 74 internet satellites for a planned constellation of at least 648 spacecraft. Starlink satellites would fly considerably lower than the A-train, traveling through space at an altitude of 550 kilometers. Now, in our second update related to China, we'll take a look at the news where Chinese rocket firm Galactic Energy succeeds with first orbital launch and secures funding. Chinese state media announces Series 1 launch success around 2:42 a.m. on Eastern Saturday. The Series 1 four-stage solid rocket lifted off from the Jiquan Satellite Launch Center near the Gobi Desert at 2:12 a.m. Galactic Energy, a private Chinese space service provider company, successfully sent a small satellite into orbit with the first launch of its Series 1 launch vehicle. The successful mission makes Galactic Energy the second private Chinese launch company to reach orbit. Galactic Energy is the fourth Chinese private launch company to make an orbital launch attempt with lightweight solid launchers. Series 1 solid rocket has a height of 19 meters. It has a diameter of 1.4 meters. And it has a variable launch capacity of 350 kilograms to low Earth orbit, LEO, and 230 kilograms for 700 kilometer range. It has four stages, out of which three are solid stages, and the remaining one is an advanced liquid upper stage. This Ceres 1 launch had been planned for the first half of 2020. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the launch was delayed. The 50-kilogram Tianqi 11 satellite was sent into a 500 kilometers sun-synchronous orbit. Shanghai ASES Spaceflight Technology Company developed the satellite, nominally part of the Tianqi, which means apocalypse, narrowband Internet of Things constellation for Beijing Gaodian Gauk Technology Company Limited. Galactic Energy is following the path of their competitors, iSpace and LandSpace, in starting with solid rockets but shifting to larger, more complex liquid propellant launchers. The company also recently struck a deal for the construction of a rocket research, testing, and manufacturing facility with the southwestern Chinese city of Xianyang under the administration of Chengdu. This step of Chinese government shows that, from the municipal and provincial aspect, both have support for Galactic Energy space explorations. Galactic Energy announced 200 million yuan, or $29.9 million, in a round of funding earlier this week. The round was led by Haisheng Chuangtao. The firm has raised 300 million yuan, or $43 million, in total since its establishment in February 2018. iSpace, OneSpace, and LandSpace, all of the competitors, have also in recent months secured major funding rounds, which indicate major support for commercial launch companies in China. And the addition of satellite internet to a list of new infrastructures in April by China's National Development and Reform Commission has also led to an apparent increase in funding to commercial satellite companies. Our last segment will cover a news regarding India, as they're back in the space race with the launch of Earth observation satellites having severely hit by COVID-19 pandemic. The Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, successfully carried out its first launch since the COVID-19 outbreak on the 7th of November, Saturday, sending the Earth Observation Satellite 01 and nine smaller payloads into orbit. The nine satellite payloads include four satellites from Klios Space of Luxembourg, one satellite of Lithuanian R2 Technology Demonstrator, and four Lemur small satellites for American company Spire. The launch was scheduled for late 2019, but due to COVID-19, RSRO had to launch in late 2020. Spire, an American company that provides weather, ship tracking, and aircraft tracking information from space, has previously used the PSLV to get its Lemur satellites into orbit. The Klios exploration satellites are intended to detect and geolocate maritime radio frequency transmissions. Klios has plans to launch and operate up to 20 groups of satellites to create a network circle to provide monitoring of global events. The company takes the South China Sea, East and West African coasts, and Strait of Hormuz as their next launch places. From the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota at 4:42 a.m. Eastern Time on the 7th of November, PSLV C-49, or Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle C-49, lifted off after a short delay due to bad weather. The PSLV-DL variant used for the mission have two side boosters. After 16 minutes, the Earth Observation Satellite 01 was successfully injected into a 575-kilometer circular orbit. ISRO tweeted, "All nine customer satellites successfully separated and injected into their intended orbit on the 7th of November." The Earth Observation Satellite 01 is a synthetic aperture radar satellite weighing approximately 628 kilograms with all-weather and day and night observation capability. It's part of ISRO's RISAT series of SAR satellites and originally named RISAT-2BR2. According to ISRO, Earth Observation Satellite 01 is intended for applications in forestry, agriculture, and disaster management. ISRO announced that all payloads had been successfully placed into their intended orbits. India is planning to launch the GSAT-12R communication satellite into geostationary transfer orbit in December. For this launch, ISRO will use the PSLV-XL, which have larger strap-on boosters. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.